but she's also determined to not be bullied, threatened, or harassed into silence. She was on Tucker Carlson. She mentioned travel plans, which means she's fleeing her home. Which was the goal. The goal is to scare her and send people to her house with pitchforks and torches. That was the goal.
Butt kickers allowed.
That takes remarkable courage that few people possess. They may have exposed her, but they'll never stop her. Long live lips of TikTok, excuse me. The Babylon Bee didn't do a deal with her. The
so
Bee is a satire
publication.
You know, like the Washington Post. I did a deal with her personally. Also, I want to thank you for amplifying the voices you tried to suppress. Your promotion of those on TikTok today has been priceless.
When streaming will
just
not
like
be
that.
Played. Really?
Seth Dillon has allowed lips of TikTok
strikes
to become professional at what they do. Don't be surprised by the support she receives.
Weird.
Want them to know that she won't be canceled from her job because this is her job now. We worked out a deal with her that will turn her heroic, high-risk work into a career. And again, he pointed out that this is not the Babylon Bee that's doing it. This is a personal arrangement with Seth Dillon and the owner of TikTok. So, there you go. Happy ending. This now turns into a career. She's going to go on vacation for a little bit, kind of chill out, relax, come back, everything's died down a little bit, and then make some money doing what she does best, exposing left with their own words. Now, I mean, just as an aside, okay, this is an unrelated story that is 100% related, okay? A family sex show, which is sex ed production aimed at kids as young as 5, which features non-sexual nudity, was canceled in the UK after unprecedented threats. Another pissed off parents. What does Libs of TikTok do? Exposes crap like this. That's what they do. And if Libs of TikTok is what it takes for people to be informed about what's happening in their kids' school, so be it. So be it. If what they were doing wasn't controversial, then it wouldn't be a problem. But it is. And the only reason they're telling everybody about it is because their egos will not allow them to be silent. So the family sex show is sex education stage production aimed at children as young as 5 years old that features non-sexual nudity. Has been canceled in the United Kingdom after unprecedented threats launched at the company putting on the show. The show features non-sexual nudity and explores topics such as consent, pleasure, queerness, and gender.
I need
coffee. They're totally not grooming you. Anybody out there got 5-year-olds or has had 5-year-olds? I've got
coffee.
None of this is on their radar.
No kidding.
None of it's on their radar. It's not appropriate. It's not age appropriate.
I'll be back.
It's designed to basically steer the development of somebody in a specific direction which benefits a community that person likely would have never been a part of to begin with because there's so few people in that community. And that is the ultimate truth. And that's why places like Libs of TikTok and what we do and what other people do is so important. We need your support. I need you to hit that subscribe button. I need you to share shows like this with other people on social media. I need you, if you have a newsletter, send it out to your subscribers. I need that because we have to grow here. Most of you know we've had to become nomadic because we were kicked off of multiple platforms. Why? Because we simply publish science. And as a result of that, it doesn't do me any good to publish on YouTube. Yeah, I still do occasionally, but it doesn't really do me any good. So this is very important for you to do. Please hit subscribe. Please go to my website, theburningtruth.us. Sign up for my newsletter. It's totally free. Get the daily show prep there. Get the podcast. Get the videos. Get the other posts. It's a conservative news aggregator anyway. So it can be your homepage. Every morning you go there and you get the latest updates on the news. The new website, which will be coming out soon, has an even better news aggregator that works better. Really happy about it. For those of you who are on Discord and are beta testing my new social network, major update to it today. I bought the premium access to it, so tons of new features, including hashtags and everything else, are on the new social network that we're building. So definitely go log in, check that out. Please try to post there at least once a day. We need to test it, make sure everything works, and if there's any issues with it, I need to know about it so I get it fixed before we go public in the next week or so. So again, if you're on the beta testing for BT Media, please utilize that social network. So that way we can get it published. and I'll be importing posts and things like that over here in short order. But I need those subscribes on Rumble, big time. Podcast is blowing up on Spotify, and that's awesome. That's amazing. But Rumble is where we do the live stream. And if I ever, God forbid, lose my job or you know, have to walk away from Federated Media, I need people who are going to be able to, I need to be able to reach out to you. So I need you on the newsletter, and I need you on Rumble. It is imperative. Okay? Please hit that subscribe button. All right, ladies and gentlemen, awkward pause before I hit end so I don't cut myself off. We'll see you this afternoon at 3 o'clock for the radio show.
Done? I think Casey may be done, because I don't hear him. GT6! Loved it! Wow, 2013? Damn, 10 years ago almost. Iced coffee with a little bit of the leftover M&M's Creamer Coffee Mate. Tablespoon of sugar from earlier, so there's about maybe that much left in there. I just put straight black in it. I can taste the chocolate a little bit, but not so much the sugar that's in there. It's drinkable, it's tolerable. I just don't prefer my coffee black. You know, I've never had excellent coffee though. I've had espresso, you know, made in front of me, and that obviously was black, and it was super ass damn strong. It was delicious. Okay, so Casey is done, apparently. Okay, what are we doing now? Is it restarting? Rewind, can I? Nope, cannot rewind. Alright, good show, Casey. Unfortunately, I didn't see the entire thing. Yeah, so now you gotta let it render and post, which takes like a half an hour. So I am streaming on Twitch right now. That sounds so horrible, doesn't it? Alright, something's getting loose. Good dream. Hopefully the copyright strike crap is actually working. Still want to be able to play Spotify though.
How loud
this is. You know what? I might have to be turning it down anyway. Because I don't know how loud it is for you guys. Go live, please. Go live. Go live. I can't fast forward it. Come on, man. Seriously? I can't fast forward it. I'm more broadcasting it. Why can't I fast forward this? Wow. Somewhere else within Twitch. Make that video go away. Oh, come on. I can't get it to live. There's gotta be a jump button. There's no go to live. I just lost a viewer because of this shit. Oh my gosh, always crap. Wifey Poo's not feeling all that well. I need to make sure this music is quieter. Okay. So this mic, I can only do so much with this mic. And it doesn't give you a really good way to test for background music in the game while talking on the PlayStation camera mic. And I tried using the microphone that came with my PS4 so I can do live streaming, and it doesn't work. It's not eligible, I guess. Seriously? Okay. Okay. I can actually adjust that, dumbass. Anyway. Okay. Actually, there's a background music master volume, isn't there? Yes, there is. Why didn't this say 4? Yeah, I can't tell how loud that actually is right now. hear it in real time, you know? Okay, so there it is. See, I don't know how loud this is coming across the stream. I'm assuming it's pretty loud because you're getting the feed directly from the game. Do some playing and testing, apparently. Okay. I ran this once so far. Let me back up. Let me go do some other crap. Damn it. Ugh. Ran it once, and it was a rather amusing experience. I did record some of it on my phone until I went to zoom in on it and it changed to slow-mo, which killed the fucking recording. Thank you, Apple. Assholes. That's fucking gay. Seriously? I'm recording and you're gonna let it go to slow-mo and then stop the recording? That's so gay. Come on, man. Gee whiz. 16th, I finished. I want to pretty up the car, though. So, that's what we're going up against. And I finished 16th. As it says, right there, 16th. And I got a clean race bonus. That's in the video. Yeah, those of you that say that this is it's a glitch and blah blah blah, it needs to be nerfed. No, it doesn't need to be nerfed. Because the people that are screaming about this so-called glitch probably got gold on all their circuit experience, gold on all the license tests, and it comes easy for them for the most part. Because they pick up what their mistakes are, and they're able to correct their mistakes right away. Not all of us can do that, and I'm in that camp. So if this is my way to get some money, it still takes a lot of skill to do it, as you're going to see later in this video. So, you know, you guys aren't speaking for all of us. We do have a voice also. We need to make money too, because that $50 million payout that y'all's got for getting gold on all the circuit experience, I'm lucky to get bronze right now on some of those, like the Ford GT Group 3 at Daytona. That's brutal. How do you guys drive that car? I know it can be made perfect. But, it's just not. You know, stuff like that, just, you know, Super License 9. That car, that Group 3 GTR, felt amazing. It was amazingly planted. It felt so good driving that car. Yeah, that one. Yeah, that thing right there, that Shelby. Oh boy. No. This car is a dream to drive. This is a nightmare over here that I don't want to go back to, but I'm going to have to. So So I just heard a car either come or go. Neighbors are selling their house. So this is, they're also selling it significantly more than what it was going for last time. So, Lord bless them, whatever you have for their life. It was nice knowing them. I just hope whoever buys it, they enjoy barbecue. So I like to share in more ways than one. Look at this. This is just gorgeous. It's so planted. It's so sure-footed. It does what you want it to do. See, I don't know how loud this is for you guys. If I had control over my monitor of the screen on my phone, I could rewind back to this point and see how it sounds, or hear how it sounds, actually, but I can't. Now, I've got a pause right now, and I can't even, like, fast forward to current, to live. Twitch, you guys gotta do something about that. Unless I'm just not seeing it, which is very possible. It was nice to drive this car after the Formula, which is outstanding. The Gunsega, it's feeling nice. I need more contrast between the sand and the tarmac. Like maybe resurfacing it? Yeah, let's do that. And then you get to drive that. It's a nice car to drive. I'm actually going to try to get gold. Not right now, though. Well, let's see if I can improve, shall we? May as well. We're here. And I'm not doing a quick video anyway. We're gonna tell everyone I'm driving. And no more interruptions. I'm sorry to be sitting here doing this crap with you guys on. It's rude of me. I'm trying to get something to someone. quotation marks usually have meaning of emphasis or quoting. Okay. Alright. I'm going to close the door in case the kitty comes. I'm expecting, well, I was expecting the second half of this week, my Thrustmaster conical rubber brake mod to be coming in the mail. There was some kind of a snafu, and it probably didn't get sent out till yesterday, Tuesday. Today's Wednesday, April 20th, 2022. Been an interesting year in many ways. Thank you, Lord. Okay, let's go. Interested to see how the changes I made in the wheel are going to be affected in this car. Ships automatic. Yep. Damn it. The old Porsche. I had that in automatic because I went insane last night trying to even get one clean lap in. I'm thinking, shit, maybe I should go super slow just to get around the track to get a ghost in front of me. And I could put on the demo ghost also. I'd like to load a friend's ghost. I thought we could do that. Well, I just had the freaking chance to go back to manual. Shut up and drive, moron. Got a lift. And brake. Felt better last night. Well, the changes I made. Too much. Replay. No, that's not what I want. Ghost settings. Okay. So, my personal best ghost is on, and we're going to turn on the demo ghost. I see nowhere to do a friend's ghost. Yeah, okay. The offset interval, that's putting the ghost a little bit ahead of me. So if I catch the ghost, that means I got 5/10. It needs an opacity adjustment. Because there's times that the ghost is way too dark and needs to be more opaque, or what's another word for it? I don't know. Anyway, eye drops. Since I had my cataract surgery, my eyes feel like I'm wearing contacts again, and I need to have eye drops constantly. Feels just like that. Well, it's healthy for the eyes, anyway. But yeah, if we can adjust how not invisible, it's not invisible, damn it, how transparent, thank you, Lord, the car is, it wouldn't be like freaking me out so much. I suppose it depends on the view that you're using also. And personally, I like the standard view. Not a bumper. So the outer edges of the gauges still automatic. The outer edges of the gauges are the sides of your car. This has been proven. What has also been proven is this is the same quote view that the cockpit has. The only difference is this one does not have a cockpit. The interior of the car. Shut up and drive. And I can do that right now. I just this. Not being in control of the gearbox, it takes away your attention, to be honest. Something else might be weird. Okay, all that's off. That's off. I wonder if this would help me in the Porsche race around Spa, or the sides of the track are damp or moist or have puddles. That's probably the hardest license. Well, I don't know. Mission 34 in GT4 was a bitch that I never completed. I still have issues getting around the ring. I know it takes practice, but I haven't raced since Drive Club. I don't think I did sport at all with the wheel. As far as a regular usage, GT6. And my T500 is still doing well. I'm trying not to abuse it by like running the force feedback all the way up. Although in GT6, I did usually run like around 7 or 8. It was on the higher side. We just need more adjustments in general. Hit your apex. There's slop. It's sloppy. But that's easily dealt with. I don't have to back out. As I was saying, the sensitivity is nothing, has nothing to do with the wheel at all. Now, here is what matters. Force feedback, according to Thrustmaster, when it's set at 3, it's like a 6, or 2 is like a 5. So I'm going to bump that up. I had been running it at either a 3 or a 4, I can't remember which it was. We're going to go up over the other side. And I'm not going to mess with that. And actually, I'm going to bump that down a little bit. Well, no. I need to see what the exact difference is. What the changes I made. Ready? Go. I need to turn that light down, too. Oh, shit. What's that all about? Force feedback? Okay. So, the Tomahawk. I took the Tomahawk on Daytona, and that shit was happening. On the straight, the back straight, actually. Now, when I was on the banking, there was resistance or force feedback that was, you know, there's pushing. There was opposition from the wheel. But again, when it was on a flat straight, it was jumping around crazy like that, probably because of a dead zone issue. That's my guess. Not an expert. And my shoulders are starting to get to me also. That thing's hard to drive. When it's set up properly, it's hard to drive. It's so twitchy, it's ridiculous. Any little input on the wheel, just, wow, that's interesting. Getting wheel hot, front or back. Don't blow it. Yeah, so maybe the DD Pro will help eliminate that. Yep, there's my brake balance. Okay. Either my DD Pro or my new Thrustmaster direct drive wheel, whichever one I can get first. Yeah, I feel that pretty hard. And I should have been in second. That's why I had zero turning. My belt might need to be replaced, I don't know. Maybe the tensioner can simply tighten it up a bit. It may be loose, it may not be loose. I haven't taken it apart yet to actually verify. I'm just going based on how it feels. You know, the wheel or the belt did develop like not a soft spot, but a round spot from sitting for too long. It even talks about that in the Thrustmaster manual that you don't want to leave it sitting in one spot for an extended period of time. Well, one question I have is the warehouse, you know, that these things were stored at, how long were they sitting? What was the environment of the warehouse? Because if I recall correctly, since day one, I was always feeling a little notch right at 12 o'clock. And then at maybe 20 after or quarter after. And it's still there, you know. I did my best to every now and then give it a turn. But it's rubber, you know. It's rubber and it's pulled tightly against a pulley. Rubber stretches, and rubber can have intentions. Yeah, it definitely feels better. Wheel out. Love it. Oh shit. Alright, I'm breaking too late. I'm breaking too soon. I hate this. I hate it. I hate this hairpin. I hate it. I hate the hairpin. Damn. Now that should not happen. Unless the front end was getting up, getting light or something. I don't know. But I wasn't braking. Downforce maybe? I don't know. Something was causing that shake. It's going to come right here. Nope, didn't happen that time. Making a liar out of me. I hate when stuff is intermittent like that. What's causing it? You know, when it comes to analyzing technology, one company I know of, IT. They're really good at diagnosing technology issues. They've got a really good customer support team. They know what they're doing. I think it's because the peak is because they're in Colorado or something. It's a new company that just launched. I'm still breaking way too early, man. Anyway, this felt so nice last night. And for whatever reason, it's not feeling the same now. Probably because it was right after the filling of the car, which is a handful. Not as bad as the Porsche. Damn. Maybe the screen is too big to be sitting about 6 feet away from it. Because, well, maybe it's a vision issue with me, because I'm not seeing directly where I'm looking. What gear I'm currently in, or what gear I should be in. I'm sitting in front of a 65-inch TV, and to look at like my laps and my position, I have to actually look up in the corner. I can't just move my eye over and see it. Fourth, third, second, get on it. Maybe I should upshift the second after rotating the car. I've seen some pros do that in Z28 Gaming. I did. Okay. Need to get myself probably 129.8 and I need 127.8. Alright, so I gotta shave off a second. Alright, let's do that. I'm sorry to do that, it's kind of rude, but you're part of my life, and I appreciate you being here. Okay, now you can hear the music kind of loud, but yet I'm louder than it is, so that's what matters.
Okay.
All right, so I got to plug the phone back in. I thought about digging out my old Canon camera. It's 5.1. It's 1080p. I can connect it to a wall socket so it wouldn't have to kill the batteries, which haven't been used in 10 years plus, ever since the laptops went, you know, to the shitter. I don't even know how much memory I have on memory cards, how long I could live stream, how long I could record a live stream at 1080p, of course. And I do have a tripod that I usually use for my phone for shooting the vinyl, but I could put that behind me just above my head and shooting down the TV, if I get the angles correct, I would have to put the TV back so it's flatter. Where I'm sitting, my head is maybe, it's like almost halfway up in my rig. I think I might be sitting too close to it. yeah. Six. Does not feel nice. So I wonder if I buy this car, if it's going to handle just like this one. I wonder who tuned this car. I wonder if Kaz tuned this car. Wouldn't it be great if we had a preset? Like, I don't know, three or four presets? Depending on, what the race is, because not everybody can tune if I was dumb. Stay in the freaking... Really? I can't push it that hard. Figured out what they're doing wrong and mentally and physically adjust for it. That's got to be some kind of aero effect on gear. That's that felt nice, letting the wheel rotate back in my hand. Yeah, I knew it. Cut that corner too much. That kills a lot of my time right there. Can't make that up. It's not a race, it's a damn time trial. And races are not time trials. So you can't always put down your best lap every lap in a race. Your opponents, especially humans, need to be treated with respect and honor, and don't screw them up. Unfortunately, GT7 has the same type of a driver system that GT Sport was using. I wish they would have just ported Sport directly over. You know, for that aspect of it. Missed the Apex a lot. Damn it. Alright. I don't know if this car is two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive. Don't want to re-brake. Just want to use brakes once and then get back on the throttle. It upsets the balance of the car. Better off just lifting. This is how Gran Turismo sucks you. Getting yourself better and better and better and better and better. Putting in the work. Get rewarded for it. Yep, that's alright. I was lined up right. I don't know what RPM this car likes to be wound out to. Come on, I gotta see in the group. I'm missing the Apexes completely. Am I just turning in too late? Am I not turning enough? Or is it both? Now is when you drink your coffee, dumbass. see it. The ghost. I can't see through the ghost. Okay, that's one way. Time for the third. Break earlier. And don't let off the brake to look at your gear. So weird, because it was great last night. Check the rankings. Okay, where am I at? A lot of these guys, they just want to complete it and move on. And some of these guys here are quite competitive. Look at world rankings. Oh, what did I have to put us? Select. Okay. your replay at? Where's your replay? Buttons on this wheel are just not good for hand comfort. I don't even know where my cursor's at. Kind of like this with a PC monitor for me too. well, I'm clicking on Buddy Z28 and nothing's happening. How do I get to the replay? Aren't the replays just stored automatically? I thought they were the ghosts. No, let's go down to ghost options and see there's anything in there. So I guess the PS5, you can take your monitor and put it up at the top. And even if you use the standard view that has the mirror up there, for me, it's kind of useless because I have to look up. It's not just in my field of view. I have to look up to see it. And I'm just getting used to hitting the X button to look back behind me. Some people are really, really, really good at using the rear view mirrors, exterior rear view mirrors of cars, like my buddy Kaboom Operator. And he's over on YouTube also. I gotta try the Madden's one more time. Z28 was saying that this car kind of needs constant throttle, you know, to keep it happy. But that just goes against everything I know about braking and letting a car roll for a bit. It's really hard for me to brake and then let the car roll for more than, I don't know, a quarter of a second. You know, Formula One cars, you're either braking or throttle. But slower cars, it's not that way. I don't know how many hours I was trying this last night. But I don't want to spend much time on this because I do want to get to the other thing. Nope. You know what? Let's just get one on the board. See if I'm able to. Actually, you want to go down to first gear and then back up to second gear before you hit the throttle. That's what Z was saying. I don't know the best way to get through here except to stay off the freaking paint. Stay in the middle of the course, see the puddles. And we got a little bit of ascent wiggle. Supposedly, I can get through this without braking. I'm not a pro. Just takes practice. lots and lots of hours of practice. Shift. Sometimes a static shifter is good, sometimes on the yoke is good. One thing for sure, I don't mix up upshifting and downshifting. Get through the corner first, man. Alright, that force feedback's kind of high. Looking at my gears. Rotated first. Sorts of crap going on in this race. Kudos to the pros. Sky is more bright than it is blue. I don't know if it's the PS5 or if it's something with my TV or the game settings. With some people, their live streams, the sky is blue.
Yeah.
side. Dummy. Noob. Question is, how many more times am I gonna make that same mistake in this game? Second gear before you get on the throttle eliminates that wheel spin. This down a hair, because 5 should be like 7. Just lift, I lose it, so I can't just lift. Splash. Looking at the lollipop instead of thinking about my braking. Well, I was hearing some tires. That was a good sound from the tires. Grass. Yeah. So sensitive. Yeah, I should have been second. Yeah, that's where I deserve to be. A tutorial, I'm gonna watch Z. I might be doing that shortly. Damn it. Alright, cut in good, got out bad. Mistakes, man. Yeah, I can change that to 3. And GT6 and 5, when you set it for whatever during a run and then just restarted it, it would save it. Every time, no matter what, it brings it back to default. Little things like that, why'd you take that away? For giving me a button to engage the adjustments. And then the directional pad can be used for those adjustments. Otherwise, the directional pad could be used for, I don't know, horn, your high beams, your wipers, you know, anything you want to assign the button to. That's 4 extra buttons. Because we've got some serious lacking of button mapping going on. I need to slow down. I have to slow down and just get through there. Period. And I have to stop talking. it's such a fine line getting through there. There's not much margin for error. You gotta keep two on. In some leagues, you gotta keep four on. That's tough. I don't know, maybe that changed. Attention to what you're doing. Shifting too soon. Throttle was at. Gotta teach my brain what 10% is and what 25% is. Need to be a little bit louder when they're turned up all the way. It's amazing watching a master get through there. Car gets so much lighter when you're on throttle.
what's going on, guys? First of all, nice job making it this far. I know it's been kind of a long road trying to get all this super license stuff done, and this race is definitely a pain. So with that being said, if you guys don't care about what I have to say in terms of the guide, you can fast forward to the end of the video. And on these tutorials, I always do just a raw replay without commentary, so you can actually see my hot lap. So like I said, if you don't want to watch the guide, the step-by-step guide, you can just fast forward, watch the end of it, and then you can be on your way. But for those of you that want step-by-step instructions,
yes,
we're going to start going over it.
Please.
All right, so this track is a little bit tricky here. Now, the most obvious thing I can tell you is that you want to avoid the puddles. There's a bunch of puddles all over this track, and once you get your tires wet, you can't really recover and get a fast time on this. So really what they're trying to do on this is just put puddles actually on the driving line. So you're not gonna be taking a typical driving line on this track. So normally at Spa, you wanna go really wide, you wanna utilize the apexes properly so you can get more time. You can't do that here. If you look to your left, you can see how wet that road is. Normally we would be moving over to that side to get more time, but you're gonna see everything's gonna be different here. So as you see turn one here, this is a good trick that I realized. You're gonna brake right before the 100 meter marker. So I brake about right here. You're gonna see that's where I start. Now pay attention to this trick here. I've seen some people, they like to accelerate in first gear. That's actually not a good idea. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna want downshift to first gear and then upshift in second in mid-turn, give it a little bit of throttle and then go full throttle. You're gonna get a lot more time and you're not gonna get all that wheel spin. So watch this. Here we go, go down. First to get tight, second, little acceleration, go, just like that. That is the most optimal way to get time on that turn. Okay, so now going into this, what I'm gonna do here, my goal when you're taking, this is very, very tricky, you're gonna wanna lift first and then brake and go into third before you even make the right-hander, okay? I did try doing this in fourth, and it is possible you can do it just by practicing, but if you wanna get this kind of done and get it over with, I find that third gear is just a little bit easier to control. You can kind of, you know, control the wheel a lot easier in third gear. So right here, going into it, lift. There it is, third gear, easy, easy, easy.
How long is he on the brake for?
You can kind of, you know, control the wheel a lot easier in third gear. So right here, going into it, lift. There it is, third gear, easy, easy, easy. Floor it, lift again, floor it. So it's going to be just like that. Did you see what I said? You're going to floor it, lift, floor it. So if you stay full throttle going through that, these puddles will actually unsettle the car. So go into third, hug it kind of tight, floor it. You can go full throttle, lift again, and then go. You can't stay full throttle the whole time. You got to lift a little bit there so you can kind of glide it. Okay, so now going on to, I fast forward a little bit. Now on this side, you'll notice, you see I'm on the right a little bit? Look on the left right there. Do you see all those puddles? You cannot be on the left side going down this straight. You're gonna notice on the replay at the end, when I'm going down this straight, I'm moving over to the middle of the track. So you kind of want to be in the middle, and then as the puddles kind of decrease here, do you see that? You see how it like kind of goes away and it gets really, really small? You want to move over as far left as you can to where your left tire does not hit those puddles. And you're gonna brake slightly after the 150 meter board. So watch this. There's 150, stay in fourth. Do not shift into fifth gear. Stay into fourth, you're gonna get a better brake doing this. You will not unsettle the car. Going into this turn, you want to hold third gear as long as you can. Hold third gear, then downshift in the second, like last minute. That will cause the car to rotate in so you can get up a little bit better of a cut. So watch, brake, 150, hold third, then there's second. Nice, easy, easy, easy. This is all smooth. So all these turns, there's no reason to brake. So right there, you can actually slide the car around. So when you brake and you're in third gear and you go into second, slide it around, then make your left, slide around, just be easy and stay more of the middle of the track. So you can see if I'm too far left there or too far right, the car's gonna unsettle. So stick in the middle right here. Once again, I am using a little bit of brake here. You don't have to do this. If you were trying to go as fast as you could, I know that I can actually make this turn without braking. It just depends on how wide you are and when you lift. So you don't have to brake here. You can just lift and kind of glide the car in there. So there it is. Easy, 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 half throttle, full throttle.
So the idea is here, where you find time on this track, is giving it a little bit of throttle all the time. Don't find yourself not giving the car gas. Don't be one of those, you know, I'm going to go all in or, you know, whatever. You have to be about 5%, 10%, and then go full throttle in order to get time. So you want to go as fast as you can here. Brake right after 100 meters. You saw the sign right there. There's a 100-meter marker. You want to brake right after that. Hold third gear. Okay, same process. Hold third gear. Downshift in a second, and you want to hug this turn on the right side as much as possible. Now watch this. I'm going to stay right. I'm trying to get right because it gets sharper. A little bit of gas, and then full throttle. The key is there is to stay as far right as you can. When the car starts understeering wide, just lift a little bit more, but keep on the throttle. You need to give it gas there because there's so much time that you can make by staying right and giving it a little bit of gas. That's where you're going to pick up a lot of time. Now, what you want to do is you want to brake a little bit earlier than I did, okay? And you want to be a little bit tighter to that curb, okay? So watch how I did this. You see how far away I am? That's not good. You want to be a little bit closer to that. Don't touch the curb, but you want to be a little bit closer to get more time. And then floor it right there. I would have made up about a tenth or so if I was a little bit closer to that line. So when you're going down this street, do not stay to the left. You can see the road is wet. If you do that, it will unsettle the car.
Forward
and you won't be able to do the lap. So stay right here in the middle. This braking point is going to be right. You see where the 50-meter marker is? You can actually brake right at 50
if you want to.
I brake earlier because I don't want to take the risk of unsettling the car and it going too wide. This is a very tricky part of the track. So I brake right before the 50-meter. And then when you brake, you're going to want to give it just like maybe 20% throttle, like just a little bit, and modulate it. Because as you're modulating the gas here, you're judging how much understeer and how much room you have to go faster in this sector. This is really, really important, okay? Do not just lift. Don't just go through this turn and not hit the gas. If you do that, you're gonna lose so much. I swear, you can make up 5/10 on this turn right here. So look right here. You're gonna brake, a little bit of gas right there. See that? I'm using that to guide the car. Easy, easy, and floor it as soon as you can, okay? Just like that. Don't lift the whole way through. Just make sure you're getting a little bit of gas. And believe it or not, giving the car throttle, giving it gas, helps you not spin out, as weird as that sounds. So if you're not giving the car gas around these turns, you're gonna lose it. It's gonna get sideways on you. So the key of being quick is actually just using a little bit of throttle control to keep this car, you know, in a straight line. So right here, my braking marker is slightly after 100. If you look, you kind of see like that shadow that's right there. You see the 100, you see the two lines like on the left. It's like right there. You see on the left side, the I don't know what that is. It's like these two blue lines. That's actually my braking point. I find that to be perfect. So brake about right there. You're going to see I'm going to slam the brake. Now when you come into this turn, you're going to hold third as long as you can. That's why I always like to do that. Hold third for a long time. It's going to keep the car stable. And then once the cut begins, you're going to downshift in a second. So this way the car slows down and you're going to naturally move more to the right. You're going to want to stay to the right as much as you can because the following left turn is going to give you a lot more room to get a good exit, right? So right here, there's second gear, trying to get tight. There it is, lift. No reason to brake. And accelerate as quick as you can. Now, this point of the track right here, I just brake about right here. You can see where it starts. There's actually that little, see if you look on the right side right there, the metal railing, right when that metal railing ends, that's my braking point. So right around this point is the brake. It's not really a huge deal if you brake a little bit later or a little bit earlier here. The important part of this turn, when you brake, right, you're gonna stay and downshift in a second. And when you downshift in a second, you have to get a fast exit here. So I don't care how you do this. When you brake, you just want to make sure you have a lot of momentum going into this part of the track. The most time on this track is going to be this final turn that we're doing. These turns are so important. I'm talking maybe a full second, maybe 1.5 seconds. You can make up so much time here. So right here, stay right here to the side. Shift into third. Now, as soon as you shift into third, you're going to shift into third, lift. Go into third, make the right-hander, and lift. You have to lift. Don't brake, though. Don't brake, just go into third, lift, turn, and then modulate the throttle. You're going to feel it in the wheel. You're going to feel that the car's going to finally get under control. Once you feel that it's not going to understeer too wide, that's when you're going to go full throttle. Look, see how I'm like modulating? Look, I'm testing it. Those little pops that I'm doing right there on the gas, I'm trying to figure out when the car's going to grip. So you can go around this turn and kind of hit it a little bit and just be like, okay, wait, I got about this much. Okay, boop, go. That's what I'm doing. There it is. Then I felt it, and now we're going to go. Now, this is scary here. So you're going to keep going full throttle. Use this sign as your marker to lift, okay? So once you see me get on this, once you see me get to this sign, I'm going to lift the throttle. I'm not going to brake yet. I'm going to lift. So watch. Lift. And then there's a slight brake. So very, very important. Lift. Guide it. Stay more to this left side. And you want to slow the car down just slightly, because if you don't slow the car down a little bit here, it'll go too wide, and you're gonna hit the wet, and you're gonna spin all over the place. So you have to lift right at the sign, and then brake a little bit to slow it down. Right? We're gonna glide here. Look, see, it's going crazy. Avoid the puddle. That's why I went wide. All right. Stay in fourth. No reason to go in third gear here. You do not want to end zone the car. There's so much wet on this part of the track. If you go to third, try and accelerate too much,
coupon code you're gonna mess up.
Slower is faster when it comes to this turn right here.
CD lotion.
Great. Get there. Very, very important.
Arthritis and sore muscles. Very important. My neck is killing me. Whipped down all the time.
And you come back in, you lift. Because if you're accelerating when you're trying to make that left-hander right there, the car will just go wide. I actually started sliding out here, but you see, I kind of recovered it, right? So you want to lift going into that. You don't have to brake, and then go full throttle. Now, right here, my braking point, it's kind of the same. Right under the sign, you're going to see there's a line right here. You see that line right there? So right after that line, you're going to brake. You're going to hard brake right here. Very typical hard brake. Go into first, okay? So the reason this is also tricky, you'll make up another few tenths on this. Go into first, glide this easy right here, and then when you make this turn, right there, you heard it, upshift to second. I know that sounds weird. Some of you are like, what are you talking about? That's not going to be fast. It is, okay? Trust me. So go into first, upshift to second, give it like half throttle, and you're going to get a really smooth and a fast acceleration going into this final turn. Watch this. Second, easy floor. Look at that. No wheel spin at all. And perfect. 222.1. So there is plenty of time on this track, guys. There's no doubt in my mind. I know you can do it. This isn't as hard as it seems. You just have to be patient. You can't be crazy on the throttle. Like, if you're going slow, if you feel like you're going slow, you're probably going fast. So keep that in mind. That's it for me, guys. If you like this video, please like it. It helps with the channel, and actually just it helps me also know what you want to see. So now we're going to go to the replay. I hope you got something out of this, and I'll see you next time. Yep. See you later, guys.
Thank you. So much roll time. lot of roll time. So that was Z28 Gaming going through Super License 10, this one, turn by turn. And what I got out of that is the car needs roll. It needs to roll. So I'm gonna do my best trying to learn from mistakes and get the car to roll. I do have to start the smoker in a little while. Okay. Right, so I'm actually at the race, so it did shut it off. Good. Well, that's background music. Come on, man. Alright. Let's see what we can do. I just forgot everything I watched. And don't put the wheel on the grass. That. Yeah, I needed that way earlier. Great roll. First attempt doing that. Thank you. let it roll more. I should have been downshifting right when I wanted to break. And then, got to get used to that timing. Downshift before braking. Downshift. Let it roll low. Brake. Yeah, that was bad entry. All the way. Oh, come on. Breaking. making dumb mistakes, man. First, I'm supposed to downshift in the braking zone. Damn it, come on, man. Is thin, looks like it's wide. Hard. No, not on the braking. Still feeling the effects, which is good. This was not my purpose today, to be doing this. That's what GT does, it sucks you in. Still can't get a clean lap there. Unless I go really slow and do a cruise. Man. But that might be what I have to do to actually get acclimated. Got it to open up and got it to work. Yay. Thank you, GT Planet, for having such a wonderful user group base. Should get some more coffee, and oh crap, it's 2 o'clock actually.
Damn.
No, that's it. I'll do a lap or two around here and then just show you the chaos, but it's 2 o'clock and I have to start cooking. Take about 45 minutes to an hour to get the Smoky Mountain where it needs to be settled and dialed in for me to go ahead and throw the chicken leg quarters on. So we're going to smoke the leg quarters. Yep, we're smoking quarters. With no wood and no rub. Just the seasoning that's in the Weber Smoky Mountain. No, don't hit yours, please. Shit. Just Don't bother though. Sport softs. And my PP is at like 575,000 or something like that. But the PP in my bladder is a lot higher than that. Keep it steady, man. Because the first time I ran this, there wasn't a single lap that I didn't have a double penalty of sorts. We'll see if it changes now. At the last hairpin, if you don't brake right and turn right, the car feels like a dump truck, and then you end up in the Barry R. Super GT, and then you get a penalty because you can't get going, which is actually worse than the 30-second penalty that you acquired. Oh shit, do I not downshift? Is it not liking being downshifted? Shit. Okay, no penalties, eh? Thank you, Lord. Give me the ability to learn. Okay. 7 years, dude. They need to bring back the expressway that we had in GT5. That the really, really, really long straight across the bridge. Fun. Oh, come on now. Please stay off the wall, stupid. So bad. Fourth, fifth, and sixth. It's always used by the fourth, fifth, and sixth. Bad. Not as bad. Come on, they're coming. Come on, they're coming. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. Come on now. gotta learn the track. Wheel hop. I don't have a button set up for the hybrid. Get to know the track. You're gonna love it when you do. Better hurry up and do that. Alright, so downshifting to fifth is way too much, maybe. Shh, pay attention, man. You bitch. Why didn't I serve the penalty? Does I have to do that manually? Same thing last time. Get off the wall. Not on the track. Over cones, getting penalized. Shit. I can't see how far ahead I am. I can't see the time back. I need new glasses. Oh, come on, man. Look on the map. I can't see. I need to enlarge the map a little bit. Give us the options, please. Thank you. Up those freaking penalties, man. Active arrow makes the car snap in, I think. Maybe. It's just weird. Bad markers. Stay away from me. Intentional, and I didn't see him coming up on me. Yeah, that's kind of jerk. You can't give your dude position back, man. And then upshift. Dong. Dang! Alright, so that was a 10 or a 5, I can't recall, so I didn't see it. They're pitting. Clean race bonus for sure. Why is the car so upset now? A little bit of mechanical damage turned on. So I've got vibration constantly now. A little bit. And penalty. 20, 30 seconds, 25 seconds. I didn't see what the whole thing was. Starting lap 10. Yeah, you got your spot back, and I gotta deal with you. So did you. Good grief, man. Seconds, man. Starting lap 11. Chunks of material that went flying, or is that screen tearing? It wouldn't be so bad if it was not right in the braking zone. I gotta set up on the right side. Yeah, it'd be nice to have him. In. Yeah, the active arrows crabs. How do we drive with that though? So it can be advantageous. Of course, I'm going to finish out this race on a penalty. Well, at least I did better this time. gives your shoulders a workout if you're not used to it, which I'm not. I'm out of racing shape. Okay, let's see what the winnings are. They say it's easy. It's a good money maker. Oh, thank you. Yeah, my wheel's making the fans running like it's supposed to be. No, I'm not going to cook the chicken out of the gasser. Thank you. One final thing I do want to do with you guys, put some color on it. Casey's gonna be on in a half an hour. Yay, first. Let's see if we can do anything to it in here. Wash it, why is he wearing a mask? That's gay. It's a cultural thing, I guess. Why do you have to go all the way out just to come back out? Can't change wheels. Ziggy? Yes, Ziggy, I know. Wheels. What, Ziggy? I'm looking for silver. Silver chrome. Oh, there's chrome. Liquid metal, yellow. Or the chrome. Yellow chrome or liquid metal. Or candy metallic is a body color. Can you zoom in? I'm not seeing. Yeah. All right. Let's go with the yellow liquid metal. Can't tire on the road? Whatever. So we're just gonna leave this, you know, this way for now. I have things I have to do. That's what's coming. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for watching for as long as you did. I appreciate it. And I shall see you next time. Thank you for liking and subscribing. And those of you who are new to the channel, if you liked it, please give a like. And if you like it enough, think about subscribing. I appreciate it. Thanks. Wet pepper! Yeah, I know. I gotta go. Later. Pepper, behave. Knock it off. Hey. Hey. Ziggy. Damn it. Ziggy. Get out of here. Alright, so that is it for probably today. I don't know. We'll see. Get down! Get! Dude, are you dumb?